The Blakeslee Farm Preserve is located central to the Cherry Valley National Wildlife Refuge. So it's located smack dab on Cherry Creek, and Cherry Creek is the lifeblood of the refuge. The Cherry Valley National Wildlife Refuge is a refuge that was established to preserve the species, the places, and the people that live here. It's over 20,000 acres. It has over 80 species of concern regionally, and it's a national wildlife refuge. So I want to emphasize that because it's national, and yet we have it here in Pennsylvania. So it's a real gift that we have a wildlife refuge here, and the reason why is because this is a special place.
The Nature Conservancy has owned this property about 10 years. We purchased it from the Blakeslee family, who farmed the property for many years. And this is where our restoration project is going to be, through the Cherry Creek. And the stream over the years has degraded somewhat through erosion, the cattle eating the vegetation along the stream. So basically what we want to do with this restoration project is put the stream back together, create habitat using mostly large wood, large trees with roots, to put habitat back in the stream for macroinvertebrates and therefore more fish and other species.
We did a restoration here that's really reintroducing, putting wood back into our streams. Wood has been removed from our streams for the last 200 to 300 years. And while, you know, collectively we don't even notice that it's not there anymore, ecologically it is really missed. It provides food source, it provides temperature regulation, it provides cover for species. So it's critical. So this restoration actually worked with leaders in this field, such as the United States Forest Service, put some wood back. That's a great start. We were thrilled to have an innovative restoration like that, but we didn't want to stop there. We said, boy, we'd love to share this idea and this approach with our other practitioners. So this week, we've been with a group of 35 to 50 practitioners who've all come together to learn about large wood reintroduction back into our streams and to share. So we can think about the future, we can think about climate change, we can think about species preservation and increase our toolbox of restoration approaches to be more applicable to the future that we anticipate.
There's essentially no trees along the stream. There are eroded areas of the stream, and what we're doing was we're taking these areas that were carved out through high flows and cattle in the stream and putting it back together.
We're trying to provide that ecological uplift, and there's not a lot of habitat in the stream currently. So anything we can do to add some habitat, to reduce the amount of sediment going into the stream will provide the ecological uplift.
Wood structures of this size and type have not been used very much in Pennsylvania. So in this part of the state, it's going to become a demonstration project.
When you look at the Chesapeake Bay and the amount of sediment that's wound up there, it's a non-point source problem. So you need to address it in little increments. So every increment of stream that we can address is a valuable savings of sediment.
Key partners for us are the United States Fish and Wildlife Service. Of course, this is a wildlife refuge, so they are the leaders of that wildlife refuge. But we also have other partners, such as the United States Forest Service, who was instrumental in helping us to do this restoration. We also have critical local partners, and again, we couldn't have done it without them, such as the Friends of Cherry Valley, Trout Unlimited, Broadhead Water Association, and there's many more.
Our relationship with TNC goes back decades here in Cherry Valley. We can't do this alone. We don't have enough staff to do it, so the more partners we have and the more expertise that we can tap into, like with partners like TNC, the more work that we can get done.
There's a lot of folks that are involved on this project, and that's a really good thing because that just shows that people care about their streams in the area.
We have a community of stewardship here that enables this all to happen.
Everything here in Cherry Valley is part of our natural heritage, and I think as humans we should be looking out for that natural heritage and trying to preserve it.